بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم السلام عليكم ورحمة الله تعالى وبركاته الحمد لله الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على شرف الأنبياء والمرسلين وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين الحمد لله we are still with the blessing and the love and the mercy of Allah we are able to continue with our Islamic ta'wa program that is our life coach training program which you can get certified under Post-Islamic Psychology Center and Khalifah Education Foundation. And I have explained to you why it is very, very critical for the Ummah and for all humanity to transcend the materialistic way of life to a more balanced, holistic, integrative way of life, which I have given to you in the previous video, and the existential threat of climate change that is going to inundate the whole earth. And today we have report that the Arctic ice is melting so fast that because of temperature rise, because of fossil fuel, because of so many other factors that I've explained in the more than 15 videos before that, that we will face a calamity of a huge magnitude very, very soon. I do not know, maybe 10 years from now, but at the rate that Arctic ice is melting, Greenland is melting, we may see huge storm, and within a short period of time, you will see huge mass extinction of species. We also see huge problem of crop failure. And if there is crop failure, then you have hundreds of millions of people who will go hungry within the next 10 years. This is not talking about 30 years or 50 years or 100 years. This is the latest report from the Danish Climate Institute. So we have to be very, very cognizant of what direction humanity is going because of materialism. That's why we have to shift ourselves, our family, our society towards a positive transformation of moving towards an integrative, holistic life based on Iman, Islam and Ihsan, which I've explained many times before. So what I'm doing to do is now I have been starting about now 20 videos on Islam Heart of Love based on consciousness research, mind, body, health and so on. All this is to give you a preview of, inshallah, we'll publish after 200 or 300 videos, a grouping of understanding how we Muslims must shift from narrow sectarianism to open, beautiful, peace, base Islam. Alright, so we have explained to you the hierarchy in which how we are destroying human civilization within the next 100 years because of our atheistic materialistic way of life, and how we are going to progress in human civilization based on this integrative holistic way of life, which is all inclusive. That means we Muslims practice Islam, we have unity and diversity of all humanity, unity of diversity of all existence on this planet Earth. So I have given you the idea of idealism, the ontological paradigm. We have the ontological paradigm of materialism, which I've explained to you why it is the dominant worldview for the last 300 years, why this no meaning and purpose result in a total destruction of human civilization within the next 100 years. That is not a premise, that is not a theory, but it is a scientific reality now playing into our eyes every day as we see the destruction of the climate, the mass extinction of species, the situation of melting sea ice in the Arctic and the Antarctic and so on. So we know this is the ontological curse on human civilization that we have to overcome. So we have to move towards idealism and scriptural or revelation. That is the premise from the Islamic perspective. But from the premise of the rationalists, they want to rationalize everything. Alhamdulillah, that's good enough. We can live with that. And within, if we move away from materialism, then we have to go into idealism. If not, if we don't go into idealism, we go into skepticism, we go into fascism, we go into extremism, both from the Islamic perspective and the Western perspective. We have seen people now mass shooting in US because they think that only the white should survive on this earth. All other colored people should be shot dead. So you have the Walmart shooting, you have this shooting, that shooting, because of fascism, neo-Nazism, and so on, which is now coming. So we can have a world of chaos and turmoil and destruction because of the kind of challenges they are facing, that there will be two evil forces, the evil forces of fascism and extremism, that will then create a conflict, a global conflict of who kill who. So we have to avoid that at all costs. And Muslims and Islam, Islamic value system is very, very pertinent in shaping the future of humanity, especially the shaping the future of Muslims themselves. So if we talk about the ontological of idealism, it is based on this understanding that consciousness is the basis of all existence, and finally, to assessment, to either if we do not go into this direction, we go into fascism and extremism, or we go finally to the understanding of the mind of God, absolute consciousness. And that means this will then lead to ontological, scriptural, and revelational. This I will explain to you how we can go about. But now I'm going to give you a brief summary of idealism, because idealism is not a new, the ontology is not something new. Within idealism, we can talk about classical idealism. That means classical idealism, you have, for example, within the Western philosophical approach, we have the pre-Socratic Platonism and Neoplatonism. All right, this is where you study philosophy and you study the depth of their thinking, even in the time of the Greek. All right, and part of this Platonism and Neoplatonism and Socratic thinking has filtered into Islam through Ilmu Kalam. So we cannot deny that there are understanding of the thinking of great scholars even before Islam, Islamic thoughts insofar as the formal Islam after post Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. But the Islam that was there since the time of Adam alaihi salam. So we have other revelation, the revelational approach, which actually goes into now traditional idealism. So we have the Chinese revelational approach under Dao, and then we have the Vedic under Ayurveda, under Advaita. You have the Buddhist, and then we have the Islamic. So these are traditional idealism, which predates the modern world. And then we have idealism in terms of the modern idealism. There are many strands of idealism today, which you can study if you're interested in philosophy, in terms of Platonic idealism, epistemological idealism, subjective idealism, objective idealism, transcendental idealism, absolute idealism, and more, with the modern understanding of the science of non-duality. We are talking about the oneness of this universe. There are many sub-section of thinkers who are thinking in many directions. But that will then finally lead to, if from our perspective, to the understanding of Islam, which I'm going to explain. But just to give you an idea of what is Platonic idealism. Okay, what is idealism? Idealism is a group of metaphysical philosophies that assert reality, or reality as human can know it, is fundamentally mental. That means everything that exists is mental, or consciousness, the nature of consciousness. That means every things, even material things, are having some sort of consciousness, or fundamentally from mental, within and outside the brain. Alright, so we have all these classical idealism, traditional idealism, and idealism, which I'm giving you summary. So for example, like Platonic idealism. Platonic idealism, according to Plato, there exists a perfect realm of what he called forms and ideas. And our world merely contains shadows of that realm. This is often called Platonic realism, because Plato seems to have attributed all these forms and existence independent of any mind. Some have argued, though, that Plato nevertheless also held to the position similar to Immanuel Kant of transcendental idealism. Okay, the next one, we have this definition of epistemological idealism. Epistemological idealism, according to René Descartes, the only thing that can be known is whether it is going to be in our mind. Nothing of an external world can directly access or known about. Thus, the only true knowledge we can have is that of our own existence, a position summed up in his famous statement, "I think, therefore I am." He believed that this was the only thing about knowledge that could not be doubted or questioned. So that is epistemological. Then subjective idealism. According to subjective idealism, only ideas can be known or have any reality. This is known as solipsism or dogmatic idealism. All right. There is no claim about anything outside one's mind that may have any justification. So the propounder is a bishop, a Christian bishop, Bishop George Beckley, who carried this idea about this subjective idealism. Then we have objective idealism. This objective idealism, this is a theory that all reality is based on the perception of a single mind, usually, but not always identified with God, which then communicates its perception to the mind of everyone else. There is no time, space, or any other reality outside of the perception of this one mind. That means this God creative mind, or whatever mind you call it. Indeed, even we humans are not truly separated from it. We are more akin to cells that are part of a larger organism rather than independent objects. So objective idealism, you have people like Hegel, Frederick Schelling, Josiah Royce, and C.S. Pierce. So these are modern philosophers. Then we have, the next one is transcendental idealism. According to transcendental idealism developed by Kant, okay, all knowledge originates in the perceived phenomena, which have been organized by categories. This is also sometimes known as critical idealism, and it does not deny that external objects or an external reality exists. It just denies that we have access to the true essential nature of reality or objects, and all of it we have the perception of them. Okay, then we have absolute idealism, or similar to objective idealism, absolute idealism states that all objects are identified with an idea, and that idea, ideal knowledge, it itself a system of ideas. It is likewise monistic, it adherence as a thing that there's only one mind, which is the reality that created every existence. So that is basically a summary. You can go into very deep, but what I'm trying to give you is basically some idea where if we go from here, then we have a new worldview of humanity today. And alhamdulillah, within the Islamic perspective, we have our great scholars of the past. For example, Imam Ghazali, Ihya Ulumuddin, which we can synthesize to the modern time today. We have Ibn Sina, we have Ibn Arabi, we have Maulana Rumi, and so many of them, both in the field of psychological sciences and the sciences of the understanding of the nature of the reality of our existence. So inshallah, I'm going to introduce to you the ontological or scriptural revelation based on Islamic perspective. And for that, we can refer to many, many books. But I am indebted to my teacher. This is his book, Tenets of Islam. All right. And he described the whole metaphysical worldview within the framework of Ahli Sunnah wal Jama'ah, the tenets of Islam, and also he review a translation of the extensive commentary on Kitab Jawharatul Tauhid of Imam Burhani ad-Din al-Harun al-Alakani. So this is based on the poetry of al-Alakani, but very extensive commentary in terms of the detail within the framework of Ahli Sunnah wal Jama'ah. This is my teacher, Maulavi Babu Sahib, with which I spent many years studying with him. And this is his book. This is the man. All right. So, inshallah, I can then refer. So when I explain to you, I can refer to this book. We also can synthesize from our great scholar, the founder of ISTEC. All right. Professor Syed Naqib Al-Attas, his Prolegomena to the Metaphysics of Islam. Okay, alhamdulillah, he wrote this book in the 70s, all right, and 80s. And this is a very deep understanding of the metaphysics of Islam and the tenets within this metaphysics of Islam, which he draw from traditional sources and scientific sources. But those scientific sources happen to be in the 70s. Today, we have neurosciences, we have algorithmic information technology, we have quantum physics, we have artificial intelligence, we have so many of the new sciences, cosmology, all which actually points to the creator. So we can actually use a lot of the material here and fuse it with the scientific knowledge in the now 2019 onwards. So we can then have a synthesis, and also the synthesis from Professor Mahdi Jenkins' book and myself, this book, was Islamic psychology a transcendent model to achieve peace, happiness and success in the 21st century, and many other references which I'm going to bring about to show you that Islam has the answer for a post-modern world, a post-modern world that is moving away from ontological materialism towards ontological idealism towards revelation. And if we can do that, then we can upgrade the, at least we can protect the ummah, the 1.7 billion Muslims, from being influenced by materialism or even ontological idealism, because quite a number of them have worldviews that are not related to understanding the reality of our existence vis-a-vis Allah or vis-a-vis God. So inshallah, in my subsequent videos that I'm going to do, as I'm going to describe to you how Islam as a deen, the heart of love, can unfold over inshallah the many videos, and inshallah over time we can publish this work in the way of da'wah, in the way of living a full life, being the sincere servant of Allah, his steward and his khalifa on this earth, always striving to make ourselves good, helping others to be good, and making the world good, inshallah.